welcome to my channel. My name is Emily. This is my channel, Books for Life. So today I'm here with my May wrap-up part one. So I ended up reading 10 books during the month of May, which is pretty good. And I have a lot to say about some of them. And some of them were books that I didn't have on my radar at all. And some of them were the books that I actually had planned for the month of May. So I started off the month finishing The Girl in the Tower by Katherine Arden. Now I started this in April, but I did read most of it during the beginning of May. I loved it. This was a great sequel to The Bear and the Nightingale. I gave this 5 out of 5 stars. I think that the series is just getting better as it's going, and I really can't wait to see what happens in The Winter of the Witch. Now, I can't give you too much of a synopsis on this because this is the second, but The Bear and the Nightingale is a Russian folklore like retelling, and you follow this girl who sees like the spirits kind of that like look over the house and the community and things like that. And it's like this whole thing. It's really fascinating. The atmosphere is just done so well, and I loved it. And this was a continuation of that. So the first audiobook that I read during the month of May was A Good Girl's Guide to Murder by Holly Jackson. And I really enjoyed this. I gave this 4 out of 5 stars. In this book, you're following Pippa, and Pippa is investigating what happened a few years ago. So 5 years ago, this girl named Andy Bell, who was like the most popular girl in school, goes missing. And this boy named Sal Singh is convicted. Well, not even really convicted, because he dies before he gets convicted, but he is found to be the one who killed her. He sends a text message saying that he did it, and then they find him in the woods. And this hasn't sat well with Pippa, and so she has decided to dig back into this and figure out what really happened, because Andy Bell has never been discovered. They've never found any like history or trace of where she could have gone. And she just wants to look into this a little bit more. What was done really well was the audio of this. So if you haven't listened to this audiobook, this is one I would highly recommend. They have some great special effects. Like, she does phone interviews, so you will hear the main character in Pippa's voice, but then you hear a completely different person doing the phone, but it actually sounds like somebody's on the phone. Like, they did a great job with that. Like, if she's recording a conversation, you actually hear like the click, and it kind of is like a fuzzy sound where it sounds like it's an audio recording instead. Things like that were done really, really well. I can't even tell you how many different people participated in this audiobook, because it just had that many people in and out, and it was fabulous. The next book I listened to, because this was like less than 3 hours, maybe it was only less than 2, it was really short, was The Sleeper and the Spindle by Neil Gaiman. And this is a Sleeping Beauty and Snow White retelling. It was really dark, but I really enjoyed it. This audiobook was phenomenal. It had a lot of music, it had lots of characters, and the way that it was done character-wise, it was like the narrator, and then anytime there was dialogue, that person like said like blah blah blah, and then the narrator would be like, she asked blah blah blah, and it was the other person. So it was cool how just the dialogue was somebody else's voice, and that the narrator was consistent throughout. I don't know if I've experienced a book that was quite like that before, but I really liked it. I thought that was really good. I don't think the story was like the best retelling in the world. I gave it 4 out of 5 just because I did like it. I really think I could give it 3.5 out of 5 stars, but it was a really great audiobook, and I think that's why I enjoyed it more. I think if I were just to read this, it would not be nearly as good. This is definitely one you want to listen to. So then the next physical book I read was A Fangirl by Rainbow Rowell, and I thought this was adorable. So you follow these twins as they head off to college, and Kath is the main character, and she's not doing well with this. Like, she has a lot of social anxiety, and so the idea of going off to college is scary in itself. But her twin sister, Ren, doesn't want to room with her. And it's like the one person she's always counted on to be there, it doesn't want to be there for her. And she's really struggling with this. And she is a Simon Snow fan. Simon Snow in this world is kind of like Harry Potter in our world. And Kath writes Simon Snow fan fiction all the time. And she like really goes into that world to try to escape her own world. And that's like her coping mechanism. And it really helps her with her anxiety, but it doesn't help her fit in and make friends at college. So I really enjoyed this. I give this 4 out of 5 stars. I thought this was well done. I really want to read Carry On now that I have like that experience into the Simon Snow world. And I just thoroughly enjoyed this. I'm really glad that I finally gave it a chance. This was also a really quick read. I think maybe it only took me like two and a half days at the most. It goes by really fast. The characters are really likable. And I just thought, like, it actually just brought up so many memories of college for me, like, especially my freshman year. And it was just like a very nostalgic read. I really just loved thinking back to some of my memories in the dorm room for the first time and like what that was like, and meeting new people at college. Like, it was such an experience to have, and I loved that this brought out like a lot of those good memories. So then the next book that I listened to was Dread Nation by Justina Ireland. Now, this book was awesome. I loved this. So this is a post-Civil War zombie book. And like, I don't read a ton of zombie books, but once in a while, I'm like here for it. I enjoyed The Walking Dead before it got really weird. Like, I don't know. I just enjoy a good zombie book once in a while. So during the Civil War, specifically at the Battle of Gettysburg, right after that, actually, the dead began to walk. And Jane, our main character, was born like right before that happened, like 2 days before the dead began to walk. And so Jane's entire life, she has to face the dead. So she's living with her mom in Kentucky, but then there's this act that goes through and they are recruiting black people to like fight the dead. So Janie goes to the school, and it's supposed to help her become, you know, trained in fighting the dead, and also teach her like how to be an attendant. So an attendant is somebody who like is hired by a family, and they are like her, like the family's like protector. So Janie, this is like a really big like honor to be hired by a family, because the family then will like pay you a wage and all that, and you have like a secure future. So Jane goes to Miss Preston's School of Combat. She is sent, I think when she's like 12 or 13, to go there and learn how to truly fight the dead. Jane is the daughter of a white woman from the South, and this raises like all sorts of questions because Jane is black. And this, when her father came home from the war, there was all sorts of problems, and this just really ended up spiraling for her. And this is one of the reasons why she ends up as Miss Preston's, and she is still forced to follow like the societal expectations and become some like an attendant. Like, she can't take over the estate. So while Jane is at this school learning how to be an attendant, some people go missing, and Jane finds herself in the middle of this conspiracy, and she has to try to figure out what to do, who she can trust, and how she's going to save not only her life but the life of her friends, all while fighting zombies. And I just loved it. I am definitely going to continue listening to this series. I loved the main character. She was so bold and stubborn and sassy. She just, like, I just loved her. You never knew like quite what she was going to do or quite what she was going to say. Like, I couldn't always anticipate her. And she had a lot of character development throughout. Like, she really grew as a person, and you learned with her as she was like finding things out. And I loved, loved, loved her as a character. This was a phenomenal book. I really, really enjoyed it. And the last book that I'm going to tell you about during this one is Red Rising by Pierce Brown. This is a sci-fi dystopian novel. This takes place on Mars. You are following this main character named Darrow, and Darrow is a red. Now, the way that this world is set up is it's kind of like a caste system with different colors. So like, the people who are reds have like red eyes and red hair. And if you are a gold, you have gold eyes and gold hair, and your color sets you up like in your societal rank. Now, reds are getting the planet ready for humans to be able to enter. So Darrow has had everything taken away from him. His wife was taken, his people were enslaved, and he's decided that he is going to help, like, rebel against the Golds. The Golds are the top of the chain here, and he's going to do everything he can. Now, this first book was very Hunger Games-esque, and, like, once you got into it, but I loved it. This was ruthless and dark, and there were things that happened that I never expected. I don't really know that I even consider this YA. I'm not sure if it is considered YA, but I definitely think this is adult. Like, some trigger warnings, there are, there's a fair amount of death. There are some truly, like, gruesome scenes, with, like, limbs and eyeballs and stuff like that. There's rape. So there's definitely a lot of dark things that happen in this book, but I really, really enjoyed it. And I'm so excited to see where this story goes. So I give this book 5 out of 5 stars. So that's the first part of this wrap up. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit subscribe, and I'll be back with part 2 soon. As always, keep reading.